Hello, in this video, if you're choosing to kind of follow this programming from A to Z playlist as a course that you're doing over some period of time, I'm going to talk you through a homework assignment or exercise that I think is useful to do before you move on to the next set of videos. And if you're interested in participating in a Slack channel where you can share and discuss these assignments, please check this video's description for a link to the Patreon crowdfunding system that I'm using for that particular Slack channel. But of course, you could just do it and share it with me on Twitter or in the YouTube comments, and I'd love to see the things you guys are making. So here's what I think you should do. Number one is I think, in the previous coding challenge where I implemented Jack's McBlow's diastic technique, one of the things that you can try to do for this homework assignment is invent your own constrained writing technique. So constrained writing is a sort of form of writing based on an algorithm or some sets of constraints. There's a French collective of writers known as Oulipo, who pioneered a bunch of different techniques. One of them is known as the N+7 technique. This is a nice website, which I will also include, which implements this particular technique. In French, it's actually referred to as S+7. And the way that this works, N+7, you look at a body of text. You look for every single noun in that text. You find the noun for every noun in a body of text. You look up that noun in the dictionary, find the seventh noun after that one, and replace it back into the text. And now you have a new text sort of with randomly generated new nouns based on the order of appearance in a dictionary. So you could try to, one thing you might do is just implement one of these algorithms, like make your own N+7 web page. You can see this web page works very similarly to a lot of the examples that I've demonstrated for you. Another kind of famous example is, this is one of my examples that you can find in the A to Z GitHub repository. This is using William Burroughs' cut-up method, which is actually a physical method of cutting up text and folding text and mashing it up. You can see that I have a slider, which sort of determines how much of the original text to keep. You can drag a file in, use a text sample. So one thing I'll mention is, this frame of reference is a good reference for it to use, where it's kind of giving the user a lot of options. Enter some text, drag a file in, use a preloaded text sample. An erasure machine, erasure poetry, not to be confused with the band erasure, cue erasure music now, is a technique. I'm going to load a text sample in right now, which is a spam email that I received at one point. And you can see I'm using DOM manipulation to click on all these words and actually erase them, but I could come up with another system, like erase every seventh word, or erase every verb, or erase every word that starts with E. So, and you know, I can also, by the way, based on how I'm doing this, keep the spacing or remove the spacing, and what types of sort of generative poetry could you create out of the erasure algorithm. So, but even though I'm showing you these digital versions of it, you might want to wait until next time, after you've watched the regular expression videos, to actually implement your interactive web-based version of it. As a constraint on yourself, invent your own algorithm to do by hand. Get a newspaper, get a magazine, get a book, invent your algorithm, write the instructions for the algorithm, and execute those instructions and get your new text. And then present those instructions and present the result on a web page. So think about, one of the things I'm asking people to think about is, how do you have a self-documenting web page? So instead of presenting kind of the result and then having a blog post that explains it, could you have a web page that kind of has the instructions, has the result, kind of documents itself? And something you might consider using is GitHub Pages to host it. So get yourself set up, figure out GitHub Pages, get yourself an account, review HTML and CSS for yourself, think about creative, constrained writing techniques, and generate the content and release it online. Give that a try. Share it with me however you might find it useful to share, and I encourage you, if you want to ask questions or discuss your work with me and a group of peers, consider joining the Patreon Slack channel as well if you're enjoying what you're kind of watching so far. And I'll be back in the next set of videos. They might be there by now if you're watching this much later than when I've recorded it, but otherwise they'll be back about a week from now. Okay? And enjoy, and I will see you sometime soon. Thanks for watching.